Hello YouTube, and welcome to Captain Nav channel. So today we're gonna have a look at how we can program the FMC in flight simulator on the PMDG 777-200LR. So for this tutorial we'll use Delta Airlines flight 17 from Los Angeles to Sydney on the Boeing 777-200LR. So we'll just jump in the flight deck now and have a look at the FMC. Okay, so the first page we get is the menu page from the menu prompt here. Before we go any further, I just would like to describe the way the FMC is organized. We've got six keys on the left hand side here, which we call L1, L2, L3, 4, 5 and 6, and six keys on the right hand side, R1, R2, 3, etc, etc. Then we've got all these keys here, the upper part of the lower section, plus all the letters, space, delete, slash and clear, and the numbers as well with a dot and plus and minus. The screen itself is called the CDU, and the part here in the lower part of the screen of the CDU is the scratch pad. Okay, so the first page we get is the menu page. So we'll just disregard all the different options on the right hand side and obviously go to FMC to get to the ident page. So on this page we check that the model is correct, 777-200LR. The engine rating is correct. We have G90 engines, so correct. The nav data is ARAC 1510, is the current navigation data cycle. This is slightly different in the real aircraft, I believe. And the active database is the correct one as well, September 17th to October 14th, 2015. The drag and fuel flow entry there, we can leave as is, doesn't really apply to the aircraft. We've got inertial enter, initial position popping up, so we'll take care of that in the next section. So we go to a pause init page, and basically what we need to do now is to tell the FMC where we are. So we're gonna enter the ICAO code of the airport where we are, so it's KLAX. Can enter the gate number if you know it, if you want, it's not really necessary. And then we've got that prompt in R5 section here for set initial position. So to set the inertial position, we're going to use this GPS position. So click on R4 key here, bring it into the scratch pad, and press on R5 to set it. And our inertial position is now set. See the PFD and the ND are now all. Then we go to the root page, and from the root page we're going to use the data link feature of the 777 and click on root request. It's going to give you a menu of routes here. So because we're on a 777, go 777, and today we're gonna take the first company route between KLAX and YSSY. So select this one, it's all grayed out, and press request. So as in a real aircraft, the requesting shows there, and then the request is sent. Quite quickly we get the reply that the route up one link is ready. So we can clear the message here and load the uplink. And we got the route 1 uplink loading message, which we could clear as well. So you can see it's giving us the departure airport, KLAX, destination airport, YSSY. We've got the company route as well showing. And then what we do is that we go to the next page and carefully check that all the waypoints and airways match our flight plan. Once this is done, we go to activate and then execute. The route is now ready to go. I go up to perf init. I check that our zero fuel weight is correct. Usually it's it shows blank, but in flight simulator we already have the zero fuel weight here. Check that the reserve from the flight plan is correct. Our initial cruise altitude, our cost index, and once we're happy with all that, we can accept the uplink. If you want, then we can change the cruise CG to 30%. Here we are. As you can see, we have the wind data uplink ready, so we'll clear the message. And in the meantime, we go to departure arrival, go for our runway 24 left. Doesn't really matter about the runway. And go to LAX 7 and Vicky transition. So go back to the route page, make sure we've got the correct departure arrival airport, the runway selected for departure. We'll put the call sign Delta 17 and execute. Now we go to the legs page to make sure that the initial waypoints we have programmed in the FMC match the departure plate and the for the SID. So we can see here we've got a discontinuity. However, the discontinuity is the same from Vicky there to Sierra Charlie, Sierra X-ray Charlie. So what we're gonna do to fix the discontinuity is that we're gonna take Vicky here and stick it there. No, it doesn't work. So maybe what we can do is to take Sierra X-ray Charlie, stick it here, and this way, yeah, we get rid of the discontinuity and we still have the departure set. We execute that. Then we go to route data and load the wind data. So we should get the reply fairly soon. It's loaded. We got 25, 27, 29, 330. We got some winds there, which is good. And a decent forecast as well. Go to the VNAV page, previous page, to the decent page, which is the third page. Go to forecast and load the decent forecast. Once this is done, we can go to the NAVRAD, add up some frequencies there if you want for the ILS or for a VOR if we need to return. Then go to the progress page, check the total distance here, 6586. Closely matches the distance you have in your flight plan. And go to our route page and route copy the route 2 and then back to our route 1. Then we go back to the FMC com page. We check that all the uplinks have been loaded and none are standing by. So as you can see, everything's clear here. Then you can go to the fixed page, maybe put the airport or the navade or waypoint that defines the MSA, for example, and put 25 miles to show you the MSA. Can maybe also put 18,000 feet for the transition altitude and predicted ETA altitude prompt and R6 here. And you'll see in your ND the altitude showing at the correct location. And then the resting page for the FMC is to go to route 1 and then next page so that we can see the departure there. The last step in the FMC setup is to go back to the performance page. So go to Inifret Index Performance. We've got the zero fuel weight. We checked our fuel on board gross weight is correct according to our load sheet. Then we'll go to the thrust limit page. Because we are quite heavy today, we'll keep the performance as is. We'll use toga thrust, so we won't put an assumed temperature here. But if we were to use an assumed temperature, then we can put, for example, 30 degrees or 35 degrees in here. But we can delete that today and keep toga thrust. Then go to the takeoff page, set our takeoff flaps, which will be 15. That's according to your performance, of course. CFG, if you just press L3, it'll give you a CFG there. 27%, 5.5 for the trim. And then depending on how you do things, if you have performance software, then you can enter the speeds given by your software. Otherwise, PMDG gives you speeds there. We'll just use the PMDG speeds, so we'll take V1-161, Rotate-168, and V2-174, which makes sense. We'll just check that our VRF is 177, just as a cross-check, and then come back to the takeoff page, 174. And set 174 and the MCP for V2. And that's it. So I hope you find this video useful. If you have any questions, please let me know. And like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you very much.